I am now recording. Let's go. Alright, so welcome to the Slider Velocity Showdown results. What we're going to do is we're going to start with the map that was ranked last, and then we're going to work our way up to first place. This is not one of the entries. So, wait, no, it wasn't an entry. Get out of here. Alright, and we're going to commentate over it, because why would we not? And I'll just reflect what the judges thought of it, I guess? I think that's a good way of doing it. So, these are all the maps, and they will be posted after this stream. You can download all of them and see all the results in the comments and everything. So, for the first map, we are going to be showing this one. Where is it? This one. Charles is so, he's ready. He's ready to show it off. Yeah, this is important, Ibis. Alright, so I'm just gonna play them on auto because I can't play like half of these maps. Let's go. And I'm not skipping the intros because some of them have gimmicks in the intros. Well, I'm skipping. Oh, you'll see, whatever. Oh. Shit. How do you get rid of this overlay? H? Alright.
H, yeah.
Okay. Sick. Control H. Oh, okay. Alright. So, most of the comments for this map were commented on how simple it was, because this map doesn't have any SV at all. Well, it has no gimmicks, it has no, you know, complex SV. And it's a 3-star map, so this was, like, the easiest map of the bunch. Yeah, it was a bold move, but I'm afraid it did not work out. It did not score very high with judges. The total score of this on a scale from 0 to 30 was 4.14. With every judge, except for one, giving it a 0 in innovation, and all the other points coming from the enjoyability and execution. So this got 15th, even though there were 16 entries, and that's because there is a tie sometime in the rankings, and we'll get to that later. There is an exact tie, yeah. No, we're only revealing who made the top three, but if the people who made the maps want to reveal them themselves, they can. It's fine. And you can upload them after the stream. Yeah. At least I hope I don't accidentally leak who made any entries. I make the rules.
Don't go around leaking Charles.
Yeah. Make sure everyone doesn't know that important Ibis is Charles, H3O Charles entry. Yeah. So if you're just coming in, this is the last place map. This is the 15th entry. And again, all the judges basically commented on how simple it was. Not much really going on. And I don't know, what's some other interesting stuff? I guess I could say like the top score and the bottom score of each map, because some of them actually are really interesting. like the top score on this one was 10 out of 30 and the bottom score was 0 out of 30. So actually quite the spread.
It sounds nice.
Yeah, it's pretty quick. It is a bold map in a contest like this. I don't think this would qualify as a Muzukashi either, because of the... Oh, there's some overlap. It's subtle. Zeth, that's not true. He had SV. Are you not watching? It was right there. Alright, spinner at the end of the map. And that'll lead up into our 14th place entry. Let's go. 14th place is going to be... Alright. This guy right here. Is an igloo ghost map, and we're just gonna go right into it. Oh yeah, another. Oh shit! I didn't ping everyone. It's fine. I'll ping everyone now. All right.
Amazing display of management by NFT.
Shut the hell up. There. Alright, so, yep, this is a very conceptual map. And the scores for this one, so this one, the last map at a 4.14, this map in 14th place looks like it came out with a 11.57 out of 30. And most of the points were in, I think, innovation? Yeah. Yeah, a few of the maps were timed incorrectly by some amount of milliseconds, so. Yeah, you'll be able to see all the judging comments and scores. I'm gonna make them public after the stream. You'll also be able to download the maps, of course. I think what the judges mostly didn't like about this map was the patterning. Because as you can see, there are those finishers before the streams. Which is... not optimal. So it did get docked a few points in enjoyability, I think. Or, yeah. Let's see, what do the judges say about this actually? Is this jellyfish? Alright, people commented on how the map didn't feel very restrained in the SV. It's very bold, obviously, but they did wish that it was a bit more polished in its execution. So, great work on the placing. I'm just saying in general, not every single judge said that, but... difficult map. Half of the SV is in the notes. Music louder, it sounds quieter. Yeah, sure. Yeah, only one map had a red background, and it was yours. incredible anonymity. Another 4 minute map. Honestly, man, Igloo Ghost is hard. With rhythms and stuff. Like, I've mapped a few Igloo Ghost songs. And that dude just makes really interesting music. Yeah, Xer, you need to talk. Come on. What are your thoughts?
Okay, I'm trying to think, okay?
You're the player here. I can't even play this map.
Okay, so basically what I wanted to say is that even if it's not like the most perfect map, it is trying new things probably. Like, I cannot reveal who the mapper is, but it is a very good way to start participating in these contests.
Yeah,
like,
it's real.
Like, we're up to a decent star.
It is definitely unique. Yeah. That is, it really has that going for it, but all the other things just need a little bit more polishing.
Yeah, assuming we get like a second iteration for the contest, I hope that people take criticism not too hard.
Yeah.
All right. You know, take feedback and learn from it.
I will turn the music up. I'll just turn the volume up. Alright, how's that? Is everything good now? Alright, better. Let's move on to the next map, because all of these songs are 5 minutes long. Alright, so to 13th place, we're going to move to Impotent Ibis. Oh, actually,
I wonder who made this.
I wonder who made this map too. I called it Important Ibis in the game. Okay. Yeah, the song is 5 minutes and 30 seconds, but the map is not 5 minutes. So the playtime. All right, we'll just jump into it, and you're gonna see. So I don't think you'll be able to see this, but I have a pop-up on my screen right now that is an error with the lyrics of Time Traveler on it. Yeah, so you have to close the error, and then it loads. And the song won't play unless you skip the intro, so... This is that map. Yeah, I think it disconnected me too. No. But we get into the map by skipping the intro. And here's the map. So, if you could tell by reading the metadata, the yellow notes are all doubles, all DK, KD doubles.
Also, please do not read the metadata.
Please do not read the metadata. Oh, I need to hide it. Goodbye.
Oh, keep it, it's fine.
Yeah.
I'm sure they would like it.
So, as you can tell, the judges had the most beef with the patterning. Yeah, like Endro said, it's pretty much unplayable. And one judge actually noted that the yellow notes, whether or not they're KD or DK, is pretty much random. So yeah, I allowed the metadata just because it doesn't break the rules. Like I only disallowed, you know, skins, hit sounds, storyboards. So metadata is a clever workaround. But this map is also in 13th place, so obviously it's not the only thing you can rely on. And the scoring on this, it got a 13.29 out of 30. And yeah, pretty much every judge gave it not over anything. The lowest score on innovation was a 6. But a lot of 10s. I believe this was the most 10 map, and all of those were for innovation. So it actually got 1, 2, 3, 4 10s out of 7 judges for innovation. So big ups on that one. But if you made a playable map, you probably would have been like top 5, I think. And some of the other gimmicks are actually really cool too, like the bar lines are neat, the bar lines earlier, and the sliders are actually pretty neat too. They look pretty cool. What do you think, Axer?
I completely agree, actually.
I agree.
I think the only problematic part about this entry is that it's not too conservative when it comes to gameplay. Like, it is extremely deep creative-wise, but gameplay-wise, it's absolutely, like, abrasive.
Yeah, it's pretty much unplayable. So, the good and the bad. Yeah, we can't hear you, Axer, because I turned up the music. What a surprise.
Well, I cannot really scream, I'm sorry.
No, you're gonna have to scream, I'm sorry.
Oh my god.
Oh, I'm back online. Oh, no, never mind. Okay. And another quirky thing with this map is that there's a note right at the end. Alright. And we're going to be moving straight into 12th place with, how many points did 12th get? That's that one.
What a great entry.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see what he comes up with next year.
14.71 points, which is like a point and a half above the last entry. We have, where is he? Pigeon. So this map is 8 stars. I'm gonna turn it down a little bit so you can hear Axer. I'll turn down the effects.
Oh, thank you. That's so nice.
Yeah, no problem. Alright. Let's go. So this map got, H. This map is 12th. And this map is very difficult. I actually didn't play this map a lot because I can't play it.
Yeah, maybe you should get good.
So, the comments on this map were that there's not a lot of gimmicks in this map. It's pretty much a rankable map if you lessen some of the SV, like the overlaps and stuff. Yeah, so this song does have... There were a few entries that were of maps that either already have gimmick maps or are already ranked, so... Yeah, I'm kind of surprised too. A lot of these rankings are quite surprising. As we get into the middle range, you'll see a lot of maps that are really up to personal preference, honestly. And here's the speed core section.
Yeah, I can't play this either.
Yeah. Yeah, a few of the judges commented on the difficulty spike. But it's just a song, so... Yeah, when mapping 340 BPM, you really need to focus on the patterns. And a few judges were not okay with the patterning used.
To be fair, that section itself is like a difficulty spike on almost every set of the song.
Yeah, that's true. And some of these results came down to song choice. And I think this might have been one of them. It's just everyone knows this song, and it already has so many good maps. So it's really hard to impress people with it. Even if you make a pretty decent map like this. The Fruko wave's coming in strong. Yeah. It is kind of on the map. This is also a pretty undermapped stream, if I had to say so. There's a gimmick. I like how universally we've kind of decided that thick lines are K's and thin lines are D's. Like, you'll see that that's a common theme among the entries. It's always thick line K, thin line D. Kind of funny.
Oh shit, you got called out.
Damn, I got called out. I'm gonna have to moderate. Alright. So that was the 12th place entry out of 16. 15 places, 16 maps. It's confusing. Moving on to 11th. I hate how it doesn't search anymore, like clears your search, whatever. Which one was 11th? It was this one. So, one of the biggest things with this map. As you can see, if you know looking for Edge of Ground, you know that this map, or this song, is like 8 minutes long. Obviously, that's not going to work. So, the mapper decided to only map one section of the song, and we're gonna see that. I skipped the intro because it's like 2 minutes long. Alright.
Thank you, based Nifty.
Yep. And I think this is a great entry, honestly. It's really surprising to see it in 11. Yeah. And the scores actually did change after I told the judges that the mapper did finish the map, but... Yeah, unfortunately, it was not enough to bump it up a lot in the rankings. Oh, and the points that this map got were 14.86, so this is barely above the last entry. It actually switched places with the last entry. Yeah, I think this is a great entry, honestly. It's just, again, that song choice. The judges really didn't appreciate that. Only like a minute and a half of the song was mapped out of 8 minutes, but...
Yeah, actually, very good song choice to try an SP map to.
Yeah, and that's it. It seems especially short because of all the other entries being like 4 minutes long. Alright, and in 10th place, we have a tie. It is an exact tie. The points are 15.71 exactly, and that continues to like the 8th digit. So the first one I'm gonna play is... Where is it? Oh, there it is. So this one doesn't have a background, but this is the first map that got 10th place. And again, these tied. They have the exact same score, so one is not better than the other. It's just, yeah, kind of crazy. You guys can decide which one is better and which one is worse. I don't care.
That's fair, I guess.
Oh, H. Done. So, the judge comments on this map were that they really enjoyed the atmosphere of the SV. It just seemed really well put together, I guess. Yeah. One thing about this contest is that the judges seem to enjoy well put together maps, even if they weren't the most innovative or the most, you know, like exciting things in the world. But a map like this, I mean, it didn't score high, but you know, it scored a lot higher than some of the maps before it or underneath it, even though it is less ambitious. They thought it was a lot more put together and a lot more enjoyable. Yeah, Charles, you just have to make a playable map next time, and then you'll win. First place, it's easy. Yeah, this map got huge in enjoyability, I think. Which one is this? Paddlefish. Yeah, most of the points were in execution and enjoyability. The innovation is all like middle of the pack stuff.
I'm just silent because I'm just honestly enjoying the map.
Yeah, I get it. Alright, and moving on to our second 10th place. Yeah, we're going from lowest ranked to highest ranked. So the last map we show is going to be first. The first map we showed is the last place map. But this will be posted on YouTube, so you'll be able to see all the maps there. You can also just download them and play them and look at the sheets and stuff. Alright, moving on to our second 10th place tie. Is going to be this map. another map with no background. I'm not going to skip the intro because it does have a gimmick in it. I don't know if it shows well over stream though. I don't know how this is gonna show. Oh shit, you're right. Oh, I skipped it. Damn. Yeah, so the biggest complaint by the judges about this map is that, as you can see, there are zero BPM notes, and those get kind of annoying later on, and there's no SV on the actual notes. The only gimmick is the bar lines. But I thought this was really cool. Like, when I saw it first, I was like, holy shit, dude. And personally, I think the static notes add to the effect. But one judge actually commented that the metadata for this set is not right. It's not called Sugine. It's a longer name. Yeah, make sure to download this map. There are a few maps that I don't think aren't going to translate very well over stream. See, there was one of the zero BPM notes right there. And I believe that was a mistake made by the mapper, so. Yeah, it's pretty cool. The bar lines are nice. And it's such a simple gimmick, right? But it's so difficult to actually execute something like this. Like with the BPMs and having the notes be playable, I guess. So this actually was, I think, the most contentious map in the contest. The lowest rating was a 4, and the highest was a 21. Vocal mapping. The vocals are on the the vocals are on all of the other sounds in the song. Don't call it vocal mapping. Yeah, this is a hard map to make. I mean, all of the maps here were difficult to make, but I think this might be one of the hardest. We love slow SV streams. So that was the tie for 10th place between Paddlefish and Walrus. Why did I name these things so dumb? Alright, moving on to 9th place. Where is 9th place? Here it is. So this is the 9th place entry. Vulture. And this is sitting at 16.43 points, which is almost a full point above the last two entries. And the biggest issue that the judges had with this map is that it basically is a copy paste from the first half to the second half. So if the mapper had changed the patterns or changed the SV, it would have scored a lot higher, I believe, because this is a very well put together map in my opinion. And the gimmicks that come later are pretty cool. Or the SV, there's not really any gimmicks here. Here we go. The SV is the gimmick, yes. I think it's useful to separate the two terms for a contest like this, though. Yeah, we got some cool-ass patterns in the Ki.
Worth pointing out that Mega Fan had 3 days left and he didn't even have a song.
He didn't have it. Nope, he did not have a song. Alright. Yeah, dude, you're gonna have to play like all these maps after the stream. Except for the ones that can't be played.
A pretty solid demonstration of very good structure from Mega Fan, even with the very small time frame he had to map this.
Yeah, yeah. It's just a few good ideas executed well. But it was not enough to place higher than 9th. This again, it kind of had the same issue as Chupacabra, I think. The Reek map, where it's basically just a rankable map. There's not really anything insane in it. I mean, this part's kind of insane, but I feel like you could rank this. Like, if Skull Kid could rank Ego, I think this can be ranked.
Very insightful commentary by Nikki.
Yeah, no problem. That's what I'm here for. Yeah. Death gets it. Nothing is impossible.
Yeah, ISOC is playing his own game.
Alright. Frozen's banned. I'm sorry. Alright, we're moving into 8th place. Where is he? Here he is. So this one has a great background. It's called the Slider Velocity Showdown Map BG. And we'll just go.
Also a great diff name.
Great diff name. Great map. Awesome. That's why it's in 8th. Middle of the pack. So this map is actually, it's only 0.15 points above the last map, so the judges ranked this map very closely to the last one. Ooh, some Ki flashes. Yeah, the background should be moved down a little bit. I don't think anybody gave points off of that. And we're going into the SV section, which is pretty well executed, in my opinion. nice slow SV stuff. Again, it feels like this map could be ranked. There's not really anything unrankable in here except for the key eye flashes. Some cool 1/8 gimmick here. Nice stun comma section. Really good way of making a kind of plain section of the song interesting. Back into the haze. And just like the last entry, it's kind of copy and paste. Because the song does repeat itself, and a few judges did notice that. Yeah, just don't map the second half. Submit like a 1 minute long map. There is some SP in here that could be a little cleaner, I think, in those slowdowns and speedups. But other than that, it's executed very well. Honestly, when a map repeats itself like this, I like to make the opposite SP as I did in the first version. I think that would be kind of interesting to see, like if all those slow parts were speed-ups instead of slowdowns. But that might just be me. Alright, so that was 8th place. We are moving on to 7th, getting closer to the top 3. And that's going to be... Here we are! Susceptible, my mono. But really good song. But again, it might have the problem that this map already has a pretty decent map. So it's kind of hard to impress people if they've already played the other one. Yeah, Charles has an idea. So, Megafan gets it. The biggest problem that judges have with this map is that it wasn't crazy innovative. It didn't explore the concepts as much as it could have. Yeah, exactly, Dusky. That's what I'm saying, is that the map in Suiji was really cool. And that was made by Saren, who is already a pretty good gimmick mapper, in my opinion. Actually, when I got this and gave it to the judges, I played this map, and I played Saren's map, and I played this map, just to make sure, because I thought... So I thought this map was the same map as Saren's map, because it's not. Saren did not enter the competition, but for some reason I thought Saren just submitted their uploaded map. So, no, it is a different map. A few of the concepts are the same though. A few of the patterns are the same. It's still a solid SV map, I think. I love this section. Fucking banger. some shiny notes. I learned that those are called shiny notes. That's what Katachay calls them. They're not yellow, they're shiny.
I like the name shiny notes more.
If you want to find out whose map this is, you're just going to have to ask them. Or they might upload it, so. No, I'm not saying who. Alright, so yeah, some pretty cool bar lines, some pretty cool patterns in there. It just didn't place much higher because the judges thought that the concepts could be fleshed out a little bit more. It could have been a little bit more provocative, I guess is the word. Alright, moving on to 6th place. This one. This is 6th place. Why not? I'm not gonna give away, yep, this is number 6. I'm not gonna give away who made these entries, not until top 3. Yeah, whoever made this is cheeky, because I mapped this song for a contest, and I guess they weren't too pleased with it. And I have to agree, I think this map is better than the one I made for a contest. Or, yeah, it is. Dude, my map wasn't that good because I didn't get to choose the song. They were just like, hey, map this song. And I was like, okay, I guess. Yeah, some cool bar lines in this one. Some good patterns in this one. I'm gonna look at the scores real quick. Yeah, this map scored the most in enjoyability, definitely. Song choice isn't an inside joke, it's just that I made this song like a couple months ago and I guess someone else decided to map it. It could be a coincidence, who knows? I'm not making any accusations, but if this person wants to go, we can go. I might drop my organizer and become the entrant. Yeah, big bar lines, big ninja notes, big patterns. Everything's pretty big in this map. I think people really like that. It's big, but it's not too big, you know? Dude, you'll understand why this wasn't top three, because the top three are great. The top three are, ah. Oh yeah, I love this section. And it's over. Scared for top 5? Well, we're moving into top 5 after this one. So, you better not be scared. I forgot who mapped this, actually. This was Skunk? Oh yeah, that's who mapped it. This is a really well executed section as well, just like the rest of the map.
We're gonna head to the top 5.
Absolutely. It's top 5 time. Yeah, I got you. Oh, okay, yeah. I can try that. Just make sure the audio is off. All right, you good? Awesome. I don't think it'll impact performance. Okay, we're moving into the top five. And fifth place. Where is it? Here it is. Let's go. From's map. Nikto. Another no background. We got some cool ass bar lines during the intro. So, fifth place starts out for point values. We're going from 18.29 out of 30, and it only goes up. A unique gimmick that we haven't seen, I don't think, is the bar lines on the notes. Oh yeah, I think my performance might be going a bit down.
Well, if it's impacting the performance, I think it's fine if we can do
it. Okay. Alright. I might also just need to set my my frame rate to a better. You can still see the gimmicks well. A little bit of a Don Kama section. Really difficult. Is my stuff crashing? I can't tell. Streamlabs seems like it is freezing. Oh, I was muted. My Streamlabs is kind of freezing.
I figured you would realize.
Am I still streaming?
Yeah, you're still streaming.
Okay. Everything kind of just stopped on my Streamlabs, so as long as they get to see this fucking epic, very, 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 very fast. Oh, okay. There it goes. We're good. Yeah, the chat wasn't loading or anything. Oh, no. Alright, so yeah, that was number five. And I didn't get to read any judge comments about it, but you can find out later. Moving to Quetzal. Where is he? Here he is. Another map that already has, I think, like five gimmick maps. Yeah, here we go.
Yeah, this is definitely one of the most probably over map songs in existence.
Yeah, so many maps for this song. I'm really surprised it placed in the fourth. But I don't think it tops Kata's version, but it's still pretty good. It's still pretty decent.
Well, since it scored so high, it just simply means that the mapper did a very good job.
Yeah.
The song in a different way.
It's better than Kata's map because you can actually play it and load it. Some bar lines. The thing about this map is you can notice that it's not memorization. It's not memorization. Look at the bar lines. You can tell which note is going to be next because they're more dense or less dense, which is something I've never seen before. Very interesting gimmick. Yeah. Very creative. That's why it scored pretty high. that's why it's fourth place. Let's see, what was the point spread like for this? All over the place. Wow. Shiny notes. Yeah, Zith, I agree. I honestly didn't even notice the gimmick until right now. It could be a little bit more clear, but that didn't stop it from placing pretty damn high. So we're going to be moving into the top three, and this is when we get to say who made the map.
Finally.
God. So, third place is Rhinoceros, Lost Found Melody. And this was mapped by our very own Grape Tea. So, props to Grape Tea. Third place. Let's check it out. Yeah. This is a pretty interesting map, very well executed. The only thing the judges the only thing I think that stopped this from being first place is that the notes just don't have any SV on them. A lot of judges commented on the map being kind of plain for gameplay, but other than that, yeah, pretty much flawless. This part's awesome too. The only thing that could make this better is if the bar lines weren't on the notes, because it kind of fucks with it. Fucking great.
This is fucking insane.
Yeah, insane bar lines. Like, you can't get better, honestly. I wish there was a bit more gimmicks in this section, though. And the judges do, too. Because there's not really much to look at here. But that would be really difficult to execute, honestly, if you had all those barline gimmicks, like, along with the notes. So I don't blame him for not including them. I love that. That's so cute. Big bombs. Yeah, the top three are all great maps. Like, it was very close. Well, the point count wasn't very close. First was first by quite a bit, but you'll understand when we get to it.
Even if this entry doesn't use as many SVs on the nose as the other, it still did an amazing job when it comes to volumes and stuff.
Well,
it did what many others couldn't.
The first place entry didn't have many notes to put SV on. So This part's really cool too. A good execution of just normal SP, but it's a little bit too little too late situation. Like, if this was applied to the rest of the map, it would be, it wouldn't even be a contest. Ending with more epic good bar lines, just in case you weren't too sure about the capabilities of this mapper. So yeah, good props to Grape Tea for that map. That's third place.
Which means we're gonna be heading to second place.
That's true. Great work. Second place. The red background. The only red background. I wonder who this could be. Alright. So this was mapped by Zef. If you haven't figured that out, this is second place. Rankable map. Yeah, it is. It really is. You should rank it. Dope. Yeah, big scores on this one. The difference between second and third was actually... Let's see. Yeah, the difference between second and third was like half a point. Or not even half a point, like 0.3. So very close.
I speed map this in 3 hours because I have no idea.
Yeah, it feels like it's
a
speed map.
What a bold comment.
What a bold comment. Indeed. This is Zeth's map.
Is, yeah, Zeth. Yeah. Per usual, Zeth pumping out. Absolute banger maps.
Yeah, big on song choice here, honestly. It supports so much, like, creativity. So this scored really high, just in enjoyability and execution, even if it isn't the most creative thing in the world. It doesn't really have any gimmicks, but yeah, people, they really enjoyed it. Everyone gave it middle of the road or below average innovation though, but it's just such an enjoyable and well-made map that everyone gave it like 8s and 9s. Yeah.
The gimmick is this, if that map is rankable, yeah.
Yeah. Sometimes the most unrankable maps are the most rankable maps. Cool section. Yeah, the ending definitely could use a little bit more, but overall, great map, second place, props to Zeth for making it, and
this means we're
the moment,
to first place,
yeah.
The moment we've all waiting.
Yes, we have all been
waiting,
yes indeed, and I wonder which one it could be. This one, a 4 minute map, because of course it would be 4 minutes.
A 4 minute map made by yours truly, Cookie Tree.
Cookie Tree, yeah, really pulling it
Cookie
out for
Tree
this contest.
Cookie Tree landing first place in the first iteration of SPS.
Indeed. So, grats to him. He doesn't get a badge, but maybe next time. Let's check it out. This map was just a good execution, good gimmicks. Not, it's not overwhelming, but it's not easy. Yeah, everyone liked it. And this one by a long shot. This got a score of 24.29, with second place getting a score of 18.86. So, yeah, kind of dominated. Yeah, the only negative thing, the biggest negative thing with this map is that the timing isn't correct, but that wasn't enough to really, for like anyone to dock points for it. Yeah, the offset is a little bit off, but I think Enjiro was the only person to care. Yeah, you can kind of hear it. It's a little bit late. Oh, Genjiro didn't care. Never mind. But you did comment on it. It didn't affect your score. Yeah. Good zero BPM gimmicks. Very cool bar lines through this section. Just really clean, mixing in with the previous gimmick, some Donkama. Yeah, it basically has everything that the judges liked about all of the previous entries, but like mixed into one map. That's just really comfortable to play. Are here. I'm combining the bar line gimmick with the other bar line gimmick now. Yeah, this section is the most difficult, I think. It's kind of trippy. But it's not like impossible to read. Yeah, 3D mapping is right. Yeah, all the judges liked how the 4 minutes, it doesn't feel like 4 minutes, really. You take the whole song to flesh out all the gimmicks, so they're all really comfortable. And yeah, that's the way you get first place. Pretty cool. A couple judges commented on the slowdown here. It gets kind of insane, but yeah, it's good. That's our first place map made by Cookie Tree. So congrats. And that about wraps up the showcase for the Slider Velocity Showdown. Any last words, Axer?
I just simply really enjoyed this map. It's so cute.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, huge thanks to everyone that has chosen to participate during this first attempt at making a contest.
Yeah. Yeah. This is our first time doing
it. Huge congratulations to everyone in the top three and even below the top three.
Yeah, I'm glad that every entry had something different, you know? Every entry was unique in its own way. I'm glad there wasn't like the same thing over and over. Even though you're restricted to bar lines and SV, it's like, yeah, everyone tried. It's very cool to see. And I hope we get a lot more entries in the next iteration.
Obviously, huge congratulations to Charles for sending the entire judge into chaos.
Yeah. Yeah, there were some judges who had to edit the .osu to play the map. but there were 19 entries in total for this contest. Yeah. And we're going to be doing this again next year, maybe early next year. I'm thinking January or February. So if you're thinking about having another entry for the next iteration, you can start, not start making it, don't start making it until until we tell you to. Yeah, no problem, guys. I like doing this kind of stuff. But yeah, start thinking about gimmicks you want to put in the next contest. If you're looking to enter, try some out. Feel free to use the server to post gimmicks and see how they land with, you know, the community. And hopefully these entries gave you a little bit of inspiration for what you're going to make next.
And hopefully, maybe next time we host this contest, we're going to get a badge. Hopefully.
Yeah. This one went really well. This pretty much had zero hang-ups. So
for a test run, this was absolutely amazing.
Especially with the judges. I wanna give a shout-out to them. They didn't go late at all. Not a single one. There's seven judges, and all of them turned in their judging on time, which is cool.
Yeah.
With 2 weeks, too, for 16 maps. Which is, I mean, it seems like it wouldn't be a big deal, but in this game, oh, hey, it's Radar. Hey, yeah, so we're going to be wrapping up stream.
Yeah, we'll be wrapping up the stream.
We're going to be wrapping up the stream real quick.
To the judges.
Thanks to the comments. thanks for all of you for tuning in, especially Radar. Thanks for showing up. I'm glad to have your patronage, and nobody was talking about MBC at all.
Oh man, yeah. I just feel like my boss walked in on me playing video games. This is awful.
All right.